April the 23rd. Time is 7 o'clock p.m. in the afternoon. My name is Detective Ricardo Suarez. I'm accompanied here by Detective Sergeant Ruben De Leon and Detective Joe Vecchio. Here in front of us we have Pablo Lucio Vasquez, and I'm about ready to read him his Miranda warnings before we ask him any questions. Before you ask any questions, it is my duty to advise you of your rights and warn you of the consequences of waiving your rights. Pablo Lucio Vasquez, you have the right to remain silent and not make any statement at all. Any statement you make may be used against you in trial. Any statement you make may be used as evidence in court. You have the right to have a lawyer present to advise you prior and during any questioning. If you are unable to employ a lawyer, you have the right to have a lawyer appointed to you during the questioning. You have the right to terminate the interview at any time. Do you understand your rights, sir?
Yes, sir.
Do you wish to give me a statement on what happened on April the...
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I need you to sign, sir, here, and put your initials on each. Okay, Pablo, can you tell us what occurred? I want you to start since Friday.
Friday the 17th of April, me, Andy, Patricia, and David went to a party. We were looking for some weed, and we got invited to that party. So. We had our dog, we were walking the dog, and then we got them, so they asked us if we could come back, so we did, we took the dog home, and came back, and we were there, they asked us where to drink, so we started drinking beer, and we stayed there for at least 2 or 3 hours until it was over.
What time did you get there?
Like, 9, 8, 9. First two was early in the daytime, it was day still, and then we took off. I came back, and me and Andy and David came back, and they said we wanted to drink, so I got a beer that I was drinking, and the beer finished, so they passed a bottle of liquor, and I was drinking liquor, and by the time I knew I was really buzzing.
What type of liquor?
I don't know if it was Presidente. Because it was strong, they poured a lot into mine, and I was already feeling drunk. So somebody smoked weed in there, so I started smoking some too. And I did pot and everything.
You did what?
Coke. I did some. And, I was really loaded. And then after we decided, because the party was finishing, somebody gave us a ride. And
What time did you guys go home?
It was about 12. It was already like gonna be Saturday morning that night. It wasn't the daytime. I didn't know where that little guy was gonna go. And he took off.
What little guy?
David. And I didn't know what he was gonna do, so he followed us. He went with us. They gave us the right to the house. And me and Andy were there. He went to the back and went inside. And then I came to the back and I told Andy, what's up with the family? And he said, I don't know, he's rolling weed in the back. And I don't know, did it went there, I blacked out. I started hearing voices in my head. And I told my cousin that somebody told me to kill him. So I snuck up on him and I hit him. And then he fell down.
What'd you hit him with?
The pipe.
Where'd you get the pipe at?
It was on the floor, like where he was at. And he looked at me at first, but then Andy looked at me too, and I guess we didn't have no feeling or nothing.
Did Andy try to stop you before you hit him?
No. Well, he didn't say nothing. He just looked at me like he felt something was wrong. So I hit him.
Where'd you hit him at?
Somewhere.
What was he doing when you hit him behind the head?
Just looking at him. And then he said something, I don't know. And I hit him like 3 or 4 times. And he was right there. And he was still alive.
When you hit him 3 or 4 times, where did you hit him at?
In the head. He was still alive. And they told me, you killed him. And I go, no, he's not dead, he's still alive. So I went inside. And Andy was getting everything, like, stuff ready, so I told him we were gonna bury him. And he said, yeah. And I got him. And we took him. And Andy had the shovel.
Okay, you went inside for what?
Huh?
What'd you go inside for?
I just went inside to go check inside. Like, was anybody, I heard anything.
Was anybody awake?
Yeah. And then, like, nobody was awake. So I came back outside. And my cousin had a knife in his pocket.
Your cousin who?
Andy.
Okay.
And I saw him, and I got the knife, and I cut his throat. And then he was still like talking and stuff. And when I picked him up, I just put him on my shoulder like that, and I carried him. And I threw him on the floor because he was too heavy. And I dragged him from my hand. I picked him up, and I dragged him. And he was still saying something, and I picked him up in the air, and the blood was dripping. And it got all over my face. So I don't know, and something just told me, drink. Like, I took a drink out of water in the morning. And
You drink what?
His blood. And I don't know, and my face was covered with his blood. And I put him down because I felt weird. I don't know. And then my cousin said he's still alive or something like that. And I took him across the road right there on, what was that name? In that area where they found him.
Okay.
And he was saying something, and my cousin got the shovel and hit him like 5 or 6 times in the face. And all I knew was that, yeah, he was really
good. When you hit him on the face, what was the guy saying? What was David saying?
He was saying something, I don't know. He was mumbling something.
Any words that you can remember?
No. He was just saying, I don't know if he said help or something, but he was saying something. But I heard it was, I seen his blood, his concussion, I heard it, and I started, I panicked, so I go, let's go put him back there. So we took him back there, and we started digging the hole, and the dirt was too hard, so we just dug a little tiny hole, and I put him there, and by the time I knew it, I was just finding stuff to cover him up with, and we covered him, and I put grass and pieces of wood on him, and by the time I realized, I took off his ring, but I lost it somewhere right there. And his chain was busted. I threw that away too. And from then on, we walked to Randy's house. And I took a shower. And my cousin got the clothes that was full of blood. Because I was wearing.
Your cousin who?
Andy.
Okay.
He got the boxes that I was wearing were covered with blood. And he told his mom that he was quitting. Or something like that. And
his mom was awake?
No, she wasn't. In the morning, they asked us, well, why are you doing so late? Coming home so late? No, we were drunk. He asked his dad the next morning, and the next morning I woke up. I realized that I had done something bad, and I thought, who got you? And I just wanted to get out of it. And I waited all day there, just thinking about what I had done. And I wanted to kill myself too, because I told my cousin Andy, I looked down and I felt like killing myself because I did something wrong. And he looked at me and he goes, oh no, don't do that. And after that, I told him, I want to leave. I want to leave because they find out they're going to kill me no matter what. After they say this, and my cousin goes, no, don't go another shit. And I told him, I don't have to leave. You could have done it anyway. Or got both of us in trouble with more than anything. And he said, yeah. So that day passed. The next night, that's when I saw my uncle and I had.
The next night being when?
Saturday, was already Saturday morning. Then Saturday night, I told my uncle that I was leaving because.
Your uncle who?
My uncle, Andy's dad, Chuck. And I told him that because I had did something bad. And he goes, man, he got mad at me for doing that.
What exactly did you tell him?
That I had done something bad, that I had hurt some kid really bad.
And who'd you tell this to?
My uncle.
Who's your, what's your uncle's name?
John.
John?
Yeah. Juan.
Juan?
Yeah.
So you told him Saturday night that you had done something bad?
Yeah. But then I...
Did you show him the chain?
Yeah, I showed him the chain and I said, look, this is what I took away from, but I threw it away at the same time. That same night I threw it. I don't remember because I was in the car. I tossed it.
You were in the car going...
Well, I stayed there until the next morning, right? And then I asked my uncle if I could go down back to Houston. And he said, well, I don't want no troubles. And I go, no. But I was just thinking, man, I didn't try to, you know, because everything that I did, it got back to me.
What did you do with his sandals?
Well, the sandals, that same day, they told me that, what'd you do today?
Who told you?
My cousin told me, man, you guys did something to
what, that. What cousin?
My cousin Jeremy.
Jeremy what?
Chapa. He asked me, where's Derek? I go, well, I don't know, I think he went home. But I was lying to him. And me and my cousin, we knew it, that we had killed him. And
so what did you do with the sandals?
I don't know. I got some glue from the PCP pipe, I poured it on there, and I told my cousin to leave. My cousin Jeremy to leave. Because he's the one that found them. He goes, who's the D's? And I said, well, those are mine. So I got them. And I put some of that stuff on and I made it. And we got up. And I stayed there until they melted. And then I took it home, put that over.
You lit it on fire?
Yeah.
What about the sweater? What was he wearing, David?
A white shirt, I think. I don't know how, where it came up. Because I dragged them from the shirt, too. For a little while.
The sandals were buried where?
They're melted down. I melted them. They melted them. Right beside where the dog was. You know how the sidewalk and the trees right here? Where the dog was tied?
Mm-hmm.
And we go like a little bit into the sidewalk ends right there at the corner. There's like, there should be ashes right there. Plastic stuff right down the bottom. It's right there. The evidence of that. And from then on I took off thinking, shit, I've done something bad.
Good. Who stabbed him in the stomach?
My cousin. When we were right there after, he hit him with the shovel. He had a little knife and poked him. Because he was, I don't know.
Who poked him?
My cousin had poked him in the stomach just once. Yeah. The knife was full of blood too. The next morning he washed it.
Okay. Did you guys cut off any parts of the body?
No. But just that I found a piece of bone. When we went back to the house, to see, because there was a lot of blood thrown there, and I got the water hose to wash it, and it didn't want to come out. And I went, damn, I just freaked out. And they asked me, what'd you guys do? I said that we killed a possum, and then
who,
I grabbed it.
Who asked you?
My cousin, Jeremy, they asked me, what do we do? And I said, I grabbed the possum, and my cousin Jennifer asked me too, what do we do? I said that I killed a possum, that it was trying to bite the dog. My cousin Andy told that to them, that I grabbed it in the town and turned it around at that. That's why all the blood was thrown all over the place. But actually, this one, I picked him up at that on my shoulder, and I turned him around at that, and that's when all the blood splattered out of him, and he was still talking.
What was he saying?
But I couldn't understand, because he was choking on some blood, and I had him upside down like this. His back was running like this, his stomach was like that, and his arm was just hanging up.
Who cut off his leg and his foot?
Nobody did.
Did you?
Probably an animal that smelled him or something. Cause we didn't, I don't know if my cousin hit him with the shovel all over, but all I know is that I just remember hitting him with the pipe and cutting him. But the rest of it...
When you guys were at the trying to bury him,
yeah.
Did you see your cousin do anything to him?
Well, he was just freaking out on him like, man, we killed him. He was just telling me, man, we killed him. And I go, I know if we get busted for it, we're gonna go talk for it. I go, I know that. I go, man, I feel sorry for him, because first place he should have never been with us. We should have never even been with him. And I was kind of messed up plan ever since a long time already. He's been a messed up thing. My mom's been in jail. And I couldn't see her for nothing. Because I was wanted in another town for some other things.
What things?
Because some guy, they wanted to fight me all the time. They want to fight me. They always put me in prison. Like, they made me go steal for them and stuff and take the rap for them. And I didn't want that shit anymore. And they're always saying that I'm relaxing and all this shit. And they're trying to put me down bad.
In Florida? Did you kill anybody in California?
No.
You have no trouble in California?
No, maybe because I stole a gun or whatever.
You stole a gun?
Did you use it?
Huh?
Did you use it on anybody?
No, somebody tried to use it on me, that's why I took it.
Okay, going back to when you hit him, in the back of the head, did anything?
A piece of bone popped out. That's when we went back.
From where?
From the back, somewhere right here. And I saw it on the mattress. I left there to know where it was, but I picked that piece of bone up. I remember nothing, and I put it in my pocket. And the next morning when I woke up, it was there, and my cousin Andy got it, and he left it on the toilet. That's when he got all my clothes and threw it away, because my pant was all torn like that. Where he had grabbed me, that guy had grabbed me, and I was like, whoa, I don't know, I freaked out. And she just, a lot of shit happened, and I can't.
Did he fight you back after you hit him with a pipe?
No, he stayed like 20 or something, like, he didn't know what was going on, but he was trying to say something.
Where did you guys throw the clothes at?
Whose clothes? My clothes?
Mm-hmm.
And the trash can, the trash man came the next morning, I think, or Sunday, or the Monday after that, because we put it up front. I couldn't walk because my leg was messed up, and they had to help me. Because when I jumped, because we took off running after that, we just walked out the front of the house. After we did all that, and we walked to back to the, where this 483 is at, where Andy's mom's staying. His name's Jeff. He has a car lot right there.
Mm-hmm.
And we walked back to there and we jumped the alley to the back. And I couldn't walk that bit. And Andy had to help me walk all the way back. And he was telling me just watch out, watch out. We did. And I'm sorry for killing that little guy, but if I had a chance to go back in time, I would never done it.
The autopsy says that someone, we don't know who, cut a piece of his back off. And there was a knife.
It wasn't me, it was probably Andy that did it. But I don't think Andy did it. I think when we dragged him, because we dragged him on the cement, maybe the cement scraped his back.
No, there was a nice cut all the way across his back, like a knife, or like somebody took a knife to his back and cut it, you know, and like cut it off.
We were trying to cut off his head. They were trying to cut off his head with the shovel. Kept hitting him and hitting
him. Who was?
Me and Andy, because we were trying just to tear off.
What was your reason for trying to cut off his head?
The devil was telling me to take it away from him.
Who was?
The devil was telling me to take it away from him, to keep it, and it couldn't come up. I was just freaking out because I was hearing that.
And what about Andy? What was he hearing?
He was just like going with it too, I guess.
Did Andy drink blood?
No, he threw up because he saw me doing it. I told him, if you were going to do that, go. Didn't hear him. I told him, didn't hear him. He's telling us to do it. And he heard it too. And he just went along what we did.
Have you gone back? Did you go back the next day on Saturday to go see him?
No, I didn't go back.
You never went back after that night?
What about Andy? Did he ever go back?
I don't think so. I didn't. Man,
how many times do you think you hit him on the neck trying to cut his head off?
Like 3 or 4 times.
What about Andy?
A couple more times too, but he couldn't come on. He didn't want to come on.
Which shovel were you using? A big shovel? Or?
There was this, that blue one that you guys found.
How tall, big is it?
It was like, see, it's like that, and then it's cut in like this, and it's like that. That was the one that we used. That's the only shovel that we kept.
And that's the one that Andy used to
hit him in the face. When?
How many times?
Like 4 or 5 times. Just hit him, and the guy, he kept shaking, and he kept saying to them, and he said, motherfucker, shut up. And
who said that?
My cousin said, Andy. Mm-hmm. He kept hitting him, and I just looked, and I go, Which is, like, we didn't feel nothing at that time because we were all fucked up. We were both the most, and drove up.
At that point when you guys were hitting him, did he still have his white shirt on?
I don't think so. Ooh. I think it fell off because...
Where at?
Because I pulled him and it came off and I just threw it. I don't remember. So I just picked him up at that and put him on my sword and I carried him to where we were going to bring him.
How did you guys pick out the spot?
I just walked to it, I don't know. I just walked to him. And just put him there. We put him there. Started digging and I couldn't do it anymore because I was sweating out the buzz and like even I was realizing I had done something messed up and I still kept hearing that man people just like I don't know like one side of my head telling me you did it wrong, you did it wrong, the other side telling me go ahead, keep doing it, like telling me kill him again, take his head off, keep doing it. Kill him.
Have you ever felt like that before?
Yeah, when I was going to kill myself one time.
How long ago was this?
Before I came from California.
How long ago was this?
I'm like 2 days before Christmas. But I got here on... I was on the bus right here on Christmas. And I was here on New Year's Day.
Had you been drinking when you felt that, when you heard that the first time in December?
No, sir. I was on... There was some other drug that they have out there called methamphetamine.
Where is this at, in California?
Yeah. And I got addicted. I stayed up for 2 whole weeks without sleep. And I was dressed in black and it was the middle of the night. And I climbed on top of a tree and I tied a rope on it. And I put a rope on my neck. And my uncle was calling me and I told him that I couldn't get down because somebody told me to jump and if I jump, the rope was going to take me.
What's your uncle's name?
My uncle, Guero.
What's his name?
I don't know his full name, but...
Where's this at?
California.
What part of California?
Tulare County, Visalia.
Is that where he lives at, in Visalia?
Yeah. He was freaking out on me too, but he had to come up the tree and get me down.
Did he call the police?
No, he just told me, man, he goes, not to you. He was talking me out of it. He talked me out of it. And he kept talking and then I started listening to him. And I couldn't sleep. Anymore. And then when my aunt was there and my little cousin, I saw people walking around.
Okay. People just walking around. Going back to that thing that happened here in Donna. When did you tell your Uncle Juan what you had actually done, that you had killed someone? When did you tell him?
Like, it was like, already going to be Sunday morning, that one night. Because I was telling him, because I felt really bad.
Who were you telling?
Huh?
Who were you telling?
I told him, look, I took this away from that guy.
But who did you tell?
Uncle Juan.
And who else?
Just him, no one else. And my aunt called when I was up in Conroe. She said that I was on TV or something, that they were watching me or anything, and she goes, what did you do? And I told her, why did you do it? And I go, the devil told me to do it. The devil told me to kill him. And she goes, I'm going to call you back in 10 minutes. She didn't call me back. My other cousin called me, and she just hung up on me. And like 30 minutes later, I hung up. And they were saying, are you Paul Vasquez? Yeah. And I lay down on the ground and they just uncuffed me and got me up.
Did you ever tell Arnulfo anything?
No.
Did you ever tell him it was a tacuache?
I just said that I told my uncle that we killed a tacuache.
Well, who had uncle?
My uncle Juan. And he told me, I think you killed somebody. He told me, no, you didn't kill somebody. He kept telling me. And then I said, I just nodded my head yes, but any time I killed him, I just said. And then I got the chain on my shoulder too.
Did he ask you where you guys had taken the body?
Yeah.
And what'd you tell him?
I told him, me and Andy, we buried him. I just told him.
When you were telling him, you were just telling your tío Juan? Or was there anybody else with him?
Nobody was there. Just me and Andy.
So you told him Saturday night?
Yeah, it was almost like morning.
Was the blood still Was the blood still at that place?
No, because they had asked me, what'd you guys do?
Who asked you?
My aunt.
Your aunt too?
Auntie?
Uh-huh.
She said, what you gonna do? I want to see that little boy there. I go, I guess he's at his house. I don't know. I haven't seen him. And I was lying to her. I knew that we had done something to him.
Did Danny ever give you a reason for you to do this?
Who?
Danny never gave you a reason? David? The little boy you referred to, David?
No, he was just like a little angel, man. I don't know.
He was like a little what?
A little angel. Man, I don't know, man. I guess that's what told me to take him away from everybody.
So when you hit him behind the head, he was looking at you or he was looking down?
He was looking because he was standing up. He was looking like that and he said something and I go, no, I'm sorry. And I just said,
Do you remember what he said to you?
He said, if you have papers.
Well, what do you mean papers?
To roll a joint?
Yeah. So he had marijuana or what?
Yeah, we went to, he was the one that bought it.
So was he standing up or sitting down when you hit him?
He was like this because there was the wall.
Right.
He was like this.
Okay.
And he got up, he goes, right when he got up, he looked down and he said, do you have papers? And I said, I'm sorry, but I just hit him. He said, no, you just screamed like, no. And I thought, damn.
So when you hit him the first time, he kept saying no?
No, he just said like no. And then I told him, I'm sorry. I kept telling him that I was sorry. And then I just hit him. I hit him like 3 or 4 times.
Was did David have hair on him?
No, I just hit him.
Okay, did David have hair?
Yeah.
Or was he bald?
Oh, he had hair on him.
Was it long hair or short hair?
Like, he had it come back like this. And a little bit shorter. No.
Did you all cut off the hair?
No. I think just when... Cause, like, we dragged him that way a little bit. In the cement, I think parts of his hair or some animal that got to him or something. Maybe. Or...
Is there anything else you want to say about what happened?
Mm-hmm. No, sorry for doing all that, man. I'm sure there. And I need some help.
Was Andy drunk?
We were both drunk. We wasn't good. They were storming. We were doing. I did some coke that one too.
Do you think you did it because you were drunk?
Yeah. I didn't think about it.
But you thought about going and burying him, and you thought about dragging him across the street, and you thought about cutting his neck?
Yeah, but it was insane.
And you thought about burning his tennis shoes and his sandals and burying him?
The next day, yeah, I thought that because I knew shit.
No, but during this happened, you said you did it because you were drunk, but you thought about all these things to do to try to cover up yourself?
Yeah.
So were you weren't that drunk, right?
No, I was drunk, sir. But I started thinking like, man, if they find this, they find that, they're gonna nail me back. They're still gonna nail me anyway. So I just did what anybody else would have probably done like that under situation.
Why are you telling us the truth?
Because you guys want to know the truth, and I don't want to have that inside of me all drunk, because I know I killed him. But I don't want to be like, constantly thinking about it, because it's kind of driving me crazy, and I'll end up killing myself.
Did anyone of us force you to say what you said?
No, sir, I told you because you guys want to know.
Okay, thank you.
It's now 7:32.